With the Euros being suspended till next year, we thought we would go down memory lane and talk to Mr. Leboeuf, who, of course, was part of the team that lifted the trophy back in the year 2000. Frank, what's your outstanding memory from that tournament? Looks young there, doesn't he? Looks very young.
Not so much now.
No.
Oh, come on, I'm still, come on. So what is my best memory? The thing is, we knew that after the World Cup, we had to win because we had to confirm that we were a good team, and not only because we play at home. And it started slowly but surely, and we became very, very good. I think that was really when Zidane showed his talent and the difference between the other players, that he was belonging to another planet. The luck that we had is the most memorable thing that I have, because I remember that against Spain, they missed a penalty. Of course, against Italy in the final, we thought it will be the runner-up until Wiltord and Trezeguet scored. I remember, and that's very clear to me, like 10 seconds before Wiltord equalized during that final, that I said to Emmanuel Petit and Vicente Lizarazu, it's going to be a boring evening after the game. Because we really thought we would lose, and Wiltord scored. And suddenly, we knew that it was the end for the Italians, that we would win. So that's a lesson for football, when, you know, you cannot say
shut.
That you're going to win something before the end, and that you need luck to be a winner.
Jules, where were you watching that in France?
I was in the Barrio Latino bar in the Bastille area in Paris. I was 19, and we were having a big party. And like Frank just said, people were leaving the bar before the end, because we really thought that this was not going to happen. It was not our night. The Italians were really good on that night in that final. And losing a final is never good, obviously, but losing against them is even worse, you know, because of the rivalry between the two countries. So it looked like we were going into a very doom and gloomy night. And instead, obviously, Wiltord and then Trezeguet with the golden goal changed everything. And I still remember when that volley from Trezeguet ended up in the top corner of Toldo's goal, the explosion in the bar we were in, but everywhere in Paris, was just incredible.
Meanwhile, Ian, you've seen more European championships than all of us combined. which one stands out for you?
Well, a few, actually. I was just thinking of that fantastic, stylish French team of 1984 when Platini got nine goals in the tournament. Van Basten's Dutchman in 1988. Denmark coming off the beach to win it in 1992. But for me, as an Englishman, Euro 96 was the fever pitch excitement around England at that time was incredible as that tournament went on. I do think England were the best team in it that year. They had Sheringham and Shearer up front, Steve McManaman, Darren Anderton. It was a very good team. You know, went out on penalties to Germany in the end. But it was a memorable tournament, which really did grip the nation.
A team that obviously beat Scotland in that tournament, Steve.
OK. Well, they might as well have got beat, because they never won it, did they? What's the point?
Well, you prefer to go to the semi-finals, wouldn't you?
No.
Of course you would.
No.
What do you mean, no?
Not at all. Not
you would prefer to get knocked out of the group stages.
What's I'm not bothered.
Not bothered.
Not bothered.
What has happened to you?
Not bothered. I just wallowed. Yeah. England got beat. Southgate missed the penalty. I was laughing.
You enjoyed it?
I loved every minute of it. We didn't expect to go through. But of course, as usual, we're going to win it. Typical England. We're going to win it.
Well, we were the best team at the tournament.
Well, Scotland and Darkie, you were.
Well, exactly.
Yeah, right. Don't think so.
Meanwhile, obviously no Euro connection, Ali, but you played in the Copa America.
Oh, look at
there
that.
There it's falling down.
I'm about to drop foul. That's a semi-final right there. Semi-final 2011.
Your best memory?
Best memory, well, that whole tournament it was, because it was our best representation of Venezuela and our best participation as a country in the tournament. We got all the way to the semifinals. We're not expecting to do that well. But I think the best memory of that tournament was the preparation going into it. And we were together for a month before the tournament ever started. It was competition. You wanted to be in the starting 11. You wanted to be in the 18. In order to do that, you had to be the guy next to you. It created great competition, but also great support within the team, because we knew that we weren't going to win because of individual players. We were going to win because of the team effort, the unity. And it created so much competition that actually guys understood that we needed each other if we were going to be successful. To that point, whenever that first whistle blew in the first game against Brazil, after having played against each other for a month, we wanted to destroy somebody,
right?
Somebody different. We wanted to fight against somebody and wanted to eat people alive. And it showed in the way that we play, and with great passion, with great understanding of who we were as a team and our strengths as a group, made it all the way to semifinals. And even though that was the best memory of me as a player, an international player with Venezuela, it's also the most painful memory in that semifinal, I rose above a couple of defenders from the penalty spot, hit a nice header above the goalkeeper, from the crossbar down to the goal line and out. We ended up going to penalties and losing in penalties. Could have won the game, 1-0, and the history could have been a whole lot different for us. So a great memory, yeah, but also a sad memory as well.
So you blew it for your country.
That's what I did. Exactly.
Well,
exactly that.
Always want to shine some positive light on everything.
Thanks so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. And for more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for premium content and live streaming, subscribe to ESPN+.